Remember the past testimony. Remember the last testimony. Psalm 78, verse 40 to 41. Number one is what? Remember who you are. You are a king and a prince. Number two, remember the reason for the testimony. It's a trial of your faith. For God to teach you warfare. Count it all joy. A joy is coming. You know your storm comes to announce your next level. Are you there? Read 78 Psalms. 78, 40 to 41.
How oft they prove, how oft they provoked him?
How oft they provoked him?
In the wilderness.
In the wilderness. You are in your wilderness. You don't know the benefit of wilderness. Wilderness is the only place you wear one shoe for 40 years and it will not spoil. I'm telling you, this bright new shoe my youth bought for me. You know, for the first time, I don't know if shoe can control the way you walk. I want to walk my normal way. The shoe is saying, no. The shoe only want me to walk like, I walk and they have to order it from Malaysia, from the company that made him. I don't know if some shoe control how you walk. I want to walk like people, man. Like the other. He said, no, you have to walk the way the shoe walks. And I've been walking, I try to walk into Benin, but when I walk like this, man, you know, when I walk like this. Church, are you getting what I'm saying? In your wilderness, you wear this kind of shoe for 40 years, it will not, nothing will spoil it. In your wilderness, if you will look unto God, you don't even need man. He will feed you for 40 years. In your wilderness is where you, he said, can he furnish a devil in the wilderness? It's where God can furnish a devil without you cooking. You will just wake up and see it.
Yes, sir.
Wilderness is where you see all the things and the reasons for your Canaan. If you don't pass through your wilderness, you'll be a slave in Canaan. But when you pass through your wilderness, you become a king in Canaan. If you don't pass through your wilderness, do you know how you behave? When you go, you know, understand things. Because you do not. Wilderness experiences the power that enables you. Continue. Read this and start afresh again and finish it till 41.
How often did they provoke him?
They provoke him
in the wilderness.
In the wilderness.
And grieve him in the desert.
And grieve him in the desert.
Yea, they turned back and tempted God.
They turned back and look at you are in your situation. Now, do you know when you don't remember the ones God has done before? What are you doing? You will limit God in your storm. Do you know how you limit him? Do you know when you say, hey, God cannot help me? God cannot answer my prayer. Do you know that is what you are going to do? You are not tying God with rope. Ask my wife. And I think that is where she also needs to ask. After that, her faith will become more than mine. My wife, most times, the only problem about her faith is when she's in a situation, she checks herself. She tries to check what she has and whom she is. That's the biggest problem. She becomes the judge of her life. And I keep on telling her, that's where I've been telling, you know, and I know I'm making this because that's the last hurdle for her to cross. And her faith will become a shepherd. I cannot in any situation I found myself, I start looking at her as myself. They say you used to beat your mother. They say you are weak. They say you are this. I can't. In fact, that's the best time for me to tell the devil, if you have not seen a righteous man, I'm the number one. If you have not seen a man that has no spot, I'm the number one. Why? At that situation is when God hears your heart more than what you see in heaven. Sometimes people, when they have situations, they start checking, it's because, I didn't buy this blue Mercedes. It was because it's a lie. It's not the trial, it's the trial of your faith. That is the time you have to tell devil. It's not time to start, oh, did I make a mistake? Oh, if I had greeted him good morning, if I had, it's a lie. You are limiting the power of God. You are saying, God, what is happening is because of my sin. And Archbishop Betts in the house has said, it's not the trial of your sin. It's the trial of your faith. Shut the devil up. My faith is unshakable. Shut the devil up. You can't change my mindset. He said, without faith, it's impossible to please God. Whoever that will come will believe that he is. And he is the one that I've done that diligently. So we all pass through this. And that is what, there's no challenge that will come and remind me of my past. Past failure, past mistakes, or whom I am, or how weak I was. It's the time for me to start devil face to face, because it's not about God. It's the devil. Do you know what Elisha said? He said, this woman is in sorrow, and God has not shown it to me that this woman is in trouble. But you know the truth. Elisha knew, because God has not revealed, God cannot do anything without revealing to his prophet. It's not real. It's the devil. He said, the sorrow that this woman is passing through, coming to me, she said to her husband, it shall be well. And he saw the husband that said, it is well. And moved to Elisha and said, did I ask you for a child? And Elisha looked in his archive. He said, God has not revealed this to me. And because God has not revealed to me that he's going to take the child of this woman, it means it's the devil. He looked at the devil's face. He first of all said to Gehazi, go. But Gehazi, because he's a businessman, he was thinking of how many cow am I going to do? This woman will give me $20 now. This woman will give me for his belly. So when he went and touched Elisha's sword, staff on the boy, he said, I will die more. Because your intention is to take money from my mother. And when Elijah, when he came back, he said, what happened? He said, he didn't come. He said, let's go. God has not revealed this to me. God has not revealed this to me. God, let me tell you, that's what we are passing through. God did not reveal it to you. Amen. It's not in your agenda with God. It's not in God's plan for your life.
Amen.
Why are you accepting what is not in God's plan for your life? What is not in his way? When Elijah went, he laid his hand, said, come on, come back. The boy sneezed. He said, I told you, woman, God has not revealed it to me. And even if God reveals it to you, in 29 verse 29 of Deuteronomy, he says you have the power to either accept it or refuse it. Can you read it? Deuteronomy 29, 29. Even if God reveals it to you, you have the power to either accept it or not.
The secret things belong unto the Lord.
It belongs to the Lord.
Our God. But those things which are revealed belong unto us.
The one he has revealed to you belongs to you.
And to our children forever.
It means you can change it.
That we may.
It's okay, sir. So what is the first one? Remember who you are. Who are you? I'm not hearing you. Who are you? Kings and priests. Number two, remember what?
Purpose, the reason for the storm.
The reason for the storm. What are the reasons? To teach you warfare, and it's a trial of your faith. So count it all joy. Number three, remember the last testimony. Because if you keep on looking at your feet, your situation now, you will fall. You don't know what is ahead of you. You will fall. So the first thing you have to remember, had God ever solved a problem? Do you know the first problem God solved for you was the biggest? This one is the least. When you are praying, God, if I go to Australia, yes, you are going to Australia, I will worship you, I will worship you. A lot of people that pray like that, when they came and messed up, when they saw Pastor Joseph teaching, bringing them back to where God picked them. Oh, pass me not the gentle say. Hey, Pastor, we now go back here. Hey, Pastor, when I was in Africa, that's the way they call Africa now. When I was in Africa, I prayed, God will make me go Australia. Oh, man, God has brought me up. Oh, Pastor, I repent.
The next day, Pastor, you are stupid. The same people.
Pastor, pastor has not messed up his status quo since he came from Africa to here. But you have sworn every man you see, every woman you see, you have messed yourself up. You have drank all the beer in Australian bar. Pump. You have done everything. You have messed up. You have not even go on giving. You have messed up. And when you get it, and you remember that you have been messing up, and you say, pass me not to get to say, when I was in Africa, I used to talk about those. And when pastor said, preach something against you, say, I call police. May God deliver you.
Amen.
May God deliver you.
Amen.
You don't remember the past. You don't remember when you pray in Africa. In Africa. You pray in Africa. And God brought you. God did the greatest thing by allowing you to come to Australia. If you are not in Australia, now you have a little challenge that is nothing. Instead of you remembering, he that brought me from Africa, and he that has blessed me here, I never knew I would have been living in a house like this. I never knew I would have been in a position to be helping others. I never knew he would finish it. So remember the last testimony. Finish it.
Can we see the verse again?
You read 40. Have you finished 41?
Deuteronomy?
No, Psalms. Shakabu.
Chapter
78, 40 and 41. You're having a lot of things on your head. May the Lord delete some that are not in your
head.
You are still a young man. Your brain is supposed to be pa pa pa. Even when you see mosquito, you should understand it. You know, the kind of sharp brain you should have. Yes.
Yea, they turned back and tempted God,
yeah,
and limited the Holy One of Israel.
Uh-huh.
They remembered not his hand.
The problem was they do not remember. So number one is what? The number one way to walk upon the storm of your life, number one is what? To remember whom you are. Who are you? King and priest. And where the king is, the word of a king is, there is power. Number two, remember the reason and the purpose for the storm. What are the reasons? To teach you warfare. Number two, it's not a trial, it's for your faith to grow. So count it all joy. Number three, remember the last testimony. Remember where he picked you from. If he did that, he will still do. Stop limiting him. Number four, remember your future. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Remember your future. And where is your future? What is the picture of your future? Who can help me? Preach the word of God. He who began this good work in me. He began it. He began it. Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. He who began. Are you getting the church? Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting my drift? Are you getting where I'm going? If you anytime you see storm and you practice these five steps, you will see that storm will run away. You say, I didn't know I came to the wrong place. I came to the wrong place, I'm running away. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Are you there? Is there Philippians chapter 1, verse 6? Yes.
Being confident of this very thing.
Being confident. Have your confidence on this very thing.
That he which began the good work in you.
That he that began this good work in you.
Will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ.
He will finish it. He will ask my family. We have our storm comes every 2 weeks. But you can never find out we have no storm because those storms comes to bless us. Me and my wife, we have a phrase. I said, we're going to finish it now. We say, what of if we have not done this? Which will be the last thing we do and the miracle will happen. What of if God has not advised us to do this? Because that's how a miracle is. Even the storm comes, me and my wife, will say, she has that phrase. She said, Jesus is always the way. There is always a way. And I will say, you know, sweetheart, when God will finish, you will say, what of if God has not revealed to us to do this? That will always be the last thing that will crush us. What does that mean? We are building confidence in us. He said, let this confidence be in you. That he that happened. And that is how it has been happening. We are sitting on a very great storm now. But it's not our business. What you make happen to others, that's why I'm preaching it. To bless others, it will come back to me. Remember your future. And where is your future? In the promises of God. Understand first that he that began this book, he that took you from Africa to this place, he will finish it.
Yes.
Sometimes I challenge you and say, what is it that you want in this life? Don't try to help God. Don't try to think this. Just what is it that you have? And I'm standing here as the man God has brought to lead you to your Canaan. And I'm telling you that you have desire as long as you will not give up. Because when you wake up, it's your morning. My God, the God of Archbishop Eshazar, will visit you and give you that.
Amen.
All he asks is, when the Son of Man shall come, shall he find faith? Luke chapter 18, verse 8. When I will come to give it to you, all my work is to make you to remain in the platform of faith. So that when he comes, he will give you. There's no desire that you have that will never come to pass. There's nothing. Remember your future. Psalm 46 verse 10 is fast. 46 verse 10. Fast. Remember your future.
Be still.
Be still.
And know that I am God.
And know that I am God.
I will be exalted among
you. I shall be. You see, people are saying you are God have died. He said in the same place where they are saying you are God have died, I will be exalted in that place. In the same office, sir. In the same business, sir. In the same pursuit, sir. In the same office, sir. In the same relationship, where they have asked you about your God, he said, in that same place, I shall be exalted again.
Yeah.
Read it again.
Be still.
Be still.
And know that I am God.
I am God.
I will be exalted among them. I will be exalted in the earth.
Who shall have the Lord? Get that set up. Your future, the promises of God upon your life.
For thus saith the Lord God,
the Holy One of Israel,
in returning and rest.
In returning to me, if you feel that the battle is, when I'm overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. When I'm overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. When you feel that the battle is too strong, come back to me. Come walk with me. The road is straight and narrow. Oh, come walk with me. For you cannot walk alone. Oh, the road is straight. And there are many, many dangers. Oh, come walk with me. He said, return to me. Come back. Remember this first step. That you are a king and a prince. Remember that I'm teaching you warfare. There's nothing that will come to you that will be greater than you. Remember where I picked you from. If I picked you from that place and brought you thus far, I will finish what I started. Remember the future. Finally, read 59 verse 19 for me as I am. Your future. Yes.
So shall they fear the name of the Lord.
So shall they fear the name of the Lord.
From the west.
From the west.
And his glory from the rising of the sun.
Why?
When the enemy shall
come. When the enemy will attack you.
In like a flood.
When he comes even like a flood.
The spirit of the Lord shall.
The spirit of the Lord will cause you to walk upon that star. That's your future for goodness sake. No weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. And any tongue that has ever risen against you has been condemned in judgment. You are moving forward. In the work of Christ, you are moving forward. In the work of Abraham, you are moving forward. You are crossing over the empire with spirit. In the name of Jesus, no power, no spirit, no devil can stop you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Remember the word of the Lord. He that ordered his words aright. He that ordered the conversation. Remember the promises of God. Remembering the future is different from remembering the word of God. Remembering the rhema, the creative word of God, and using it. Look at what the book of Psalms 119, 49 and 50 says. Psalms 119, 49 and 50. Mashakaboya, Haramba, Dinaya. Yes.
Remember the word unto thy servant.
You see it now. Number 5 is what? Remember the word of the Lord. Remember the word of the Lord. Read it.
Upon which thou hast caused me to hope.
Mm.
This is my confidence, my comfort in my affliction. For thy word hath quickened me. The proud have made me greatly in derision.
How will you walk upon the storm? I mean, the storm will be under you and you'll be walking. Number one is what? Remember that you are a king in the day and a priest in the night. To rule over every situation. Number 2, remember the reason for the storm. It's the trial of your faith. It's for your faith to grow. And God is teaching you warfare. So count it all joy. Number 3, remember where He picked you from and how far He has brought you. Number 3,
remember the future. His promises.
He said, they shall gather in Isaiah chapter 57. Is it 54? Get it for me. Isaiah 57, verse 15.